Hello everyone, welcome back to today class. In previous class, we discussed the basic definitions of vectors and exercise problems also we discussed them. And the total this exercise 10.1 and examples based upon physics oriented exercises one. Just which is the scalar, which is the vector. Knowing purpose only this exercise will do. Now we will continue our class by the exercise 10.1. First problem, represent graphically the displacement of 40 km 30 degrees east of north. So just you draw the rough diagram. Already we discussed one example also previously. We know this is a north, east, south, west. So now, east of north means middle of east and north. So draw one line. OP represents the required displacement. This is the first block. Next slide. Problem number 2. Classify the following measures as a scalar and vector. Which is a scalar, which is a vector, we have to write here. 10 kg is a scalar. 10 kg is a scalar. Second question, 2 meters northwest. Meters measure is there, measure magnitude and direction also they mentioned. So it is a vector. Next one, 40 degrees, just degrees they given. So it is a scalar. Sir, if rotation clockwise, anti-clockwise is there, it is a vector. It is not a vector. Vector compulsory having magnitude, direction and satisfy the triangle law of vector addition. Then only it is possible to treat as a vector. So it is not a vector. What? Power also not a vector. It is a scalar. Sir, power having direction, having this value also there, magnitude and direction is there, so it is a vector. Don't treat as a vector. Why? Because it won't satisfy the one condition. That is only vector, triangle of vector addition. That we will discuss after this exercise. Next one, Coulombs also, it is a scalar. 20 meter per second square. Meter per second square is there, nothing but it is a velocity. This is acceleration. Acceleration is a vector. Meter per second square is there, that is the acceleration. So it is a vector. Next, classify the following as scalar and vector quantities. Then, which is a scalar, which is a vector. Time is a scalar. Time period is a scalar. Next one, distance. Distance also scalar. Force towards one particular direction and some amount of newton's force. So that's why it is a vector. Velocity also a vector. Next, work done is a scalar. So these are the scalars and vector classifications. Now, problem number 4 in exercise. In figure, identify the following vectors. In this figure, we have to find these 3 vectors. So here first one, co-initial vectors. Co-initial points should be same. In this one, which initial points coincide? Observe here, A bar, initial point, starting point, D bar initial point, same only. So the two vectors are co-initial, or A bar and D bar vectors are co-initial. Next step, equal vectors. Equal vectors means same magnitude and same direction. If you know the definition properly, you can write easily here. So equal means same direction and same magnitude. You observe D bar, same direction and same magnitude. These two same magnitude but different direction. So that's why it is not a equal. Next, we can write here equal vectors D bar and D bar. Equal vectors. Next one, collinear but not equal. Collinear means parallel to the same line. Not equal means anyone difficulty or that defect. Same different direction or different magnitude. You observe, I draw one line here. A bar, C bar parallel to same line but opposite in direction. Opposites in different directions. So that's why the two vectors collinear but not equal. These two are not equal. Why? Because these vectors are in different directions. So we can write A bar and C bar. Next one, fifth question. Answer the following true or false. Just if you know the definitions, we can write down which is true, which is false. A bar and minus A bar are collinear. Yes, it's collinear. Why? Because, for example, A bar is a vector. Minus A bar. So, reverse of this. You draw a line parallel to the same line. Two vectors parallel to the same line. So, it is a collinear vector. So, it is a true condition. Next one. Two collinear vectors are always equal in magnitude. Collinear vectors, no need to check about regardless of their magnitude and direction. No need to write the magnitude here. So it is a false. A vector having same magnitude are collinear. No need to discuss about just this one they wrote reverse. So this is also false. By the way, we need to discuss about the magnitude and direction, collinear vectors. Two collinear vectors having the same magnitude are equal. Same magnitude is there, means it is equal. Same magnitude and direction also there, then the two vectors are equal. So this is also false statement. So by this problem, we completed the exercise. Next, we continue the class. By the concept of addition of vectors. Normal number addition is different and vector addition is different. So we will follow one rule for vector addition. That rule only called as a triangle of vector addition. General experience. From one point A to B, one person is moving from A to B. Then he moved to B to C. So what is the net displacement? Displacement means the shortest distance between two points. So A to C is the net displacement. A to C is the net displacement. By this diagram, we can conclude AB bar plus BC bar is equal to AC bar. AB bar plus BC bar equal to A to B, B to C. Sum of these two sides equal to remaining another side. This is known as a triangle of vector. law of vector addition. Lot of members having doubt here. Sir, how it is equal, sir? AB bar plus BC bar equal to AC bar. How it is? So that purpose explanation I'll make here. First of all, we move from A to B. Next, B to C. B to C. Again, C to A. C to A. So now, starting point, initial point and terminal point is same. Initial point and terminal points is same. So that vector is zero vector. So we can write AB bar plus BC bar plus CA bar equal to zero. Why? Because initial point and terminal point is same. So now we can write AB bar plus BC bar equal to minus CA bar. AB bar plus BC bar equal to negative of a vector. Negative of a vector definition, we can take AC bar. If we are interchanging starting initial and terminal point, negative will be positive. So AB bar plus BC bar equal to AC bar. AB bar plus BC bar equal to AC bar. So this is a proof of this triangle of vector addition. So this is called a triangle of vector addition. Next, one more we will take a parallelogram law of vector addition. Parallelogram law. A bar and B bar are two adjacent sides of the parallelogram. So I will take here one parallelogram. This point O, A bar is the one side and B bar is also one side. So now I'll take this like a parallelogram. Opposite sides are equal. So this will become B bar. So now I'll join the one diagonal OABC, joining point O and point C. You observe, if you remove this one, it is a triangle. Triangle of vector addition, what? Sum of these two sides will become third side. So here, A bar plus B bar. A bar plus B bar represents the diagonal of parallelogram, which is common for both vectors. So this is called a parallelogram of vector addition. Parallelogram law. Sum represents, a simple one here, sum represents the diagonal of parallelogram. A bar plus B bar is a diagonal based upon triangle of vector addition. So now some properties is there. First property number 1, A bar and B bar, A bar and B bar, two vectors, then A bar plus B bar equal to B bar plus A bar, A bar plus B bar equal to B bar plus A bar. So this is commutative property. Next, one more property is property number 2. A bar, B bar and C bar are three vectors. A bar plus B bar plus C bar equal to A bar plus R, B bar plus C bar. This is the associative property, associative property, property 1 and property 2 based upon vector addition. So this is the parallelogram. The parallelogram is nothing but sum of the two A bar plus B bar are two vectors as a sides of parallelogram, adjacent sides of the parallelogram. Then the sum of the two vectors A bar plus B bar represent the diagonal of a parallelogram. Triangle of vector addition is A bar, B bar, C bar. A bar, AB bar plus BC bar equals to AC bar. In general also we can write here, this is the A bar vector, this is the B bar vector, then it will become A bar plus B bar. You can write like this also. This is also a vector, triangle of vector addition. Now next concept is multiplication of vector by a scalar. Multiplication of vector by a scalar. So that purpose I'll take first. Let A bar be a vector and lambda be a scalar. Lambda be a scalar. Then the product. Then the product lambda A bar, lambda A bar is called multiplication of vector by a scalar. Multiplication of vector by a scalar of A bar and lambda. Multiplication of vector A bar with the scalar lambda. Lambda A bar is the called multiplication of vector by a scalar. So now we can see here one vector A bar and vector A bar. I'll make here have this is the one unit. So now multiplying scalar. Well, scalar is nothing but a number. So 2A bar. 2A bar power greater. 1 vector so this will be 2A bar multiplication of vector by a scalar. Next step, I'll take the negative number. Negative 2A bar multiplication if you are making, it will become reverse. Will be reverse. If you are multiplying negative, the vector will be opposite to the given vector. If you multiply the positive number, same direction and reverse direction. So based upon this one, some properties is there. Lambda A bar is also vector. Lambda A bar is also a vector and collinear to the vector A bar. You observe it. A bar, 2A bar, scalar multiplication will be 2A bar. If you draw one line parallel to the two vectors parallel to the same line, so that's why it is a collinear vector. These two are collinear vectors. Negative multiplication will be the time reverse direction is there, but parallel to the same line, So that's why collinear vector. If lambda a bar is collinear to the vector a bar. This is the first point. Next step. Lambda a bar direction opposite are same to a bar direction based upon lambda positive or negative or positive. If lambda is positive, same direction will get. Lambda is negative, opposite direction will get. This is also one property. Next, the magnitude of lambda a bar. The magnitude of lambda a bar is nothing but the lambda times of magnitude of a bar. Magnitude of lambda a bar is nothing but lambda times of magnitude a bar. Next one, negative a bar minus a bar is called a additive inverse. Negative of vector A bar. So we can write here minus A bar plus A bar is equal to 0. Additive inverse is nothing but, for example, number 2 additive inverse is -2. So like that only here, vector a bar additive inverse is minus a bar, otherwise negative of a vector, just multiply minus 1, so you will get the negative vector. Next, if lambda equal to 1 by magnitude of a bar, where a bar is a non-zero vector, then magnitude of lambda a bar is equal to, this one we can write lambda magnitude of a bar. So magnitude of lambda, this magnitude is nothing but positive number is 1 by magnitude of a bar. So here also magnitude of a bar cancellation 1 into it. By this one very very important one, a unit vector in the direction of a bar is A cap is equal to A bar by magnitude of A bar or 1 by magnitude of A bar into A bar. This is a much very very important one. You need to vector finding purpose. Why? Because here 1 unit we got, magnitude of lambda A bar we got 1 unit. So unit vector, lambda a bar is a unit vector when lambda is 1 by magnitude of a bar. So this formula will use for finding the unit vectors. Always we won't find the magnitude. Just is asking unit vector means we have to find a cap is equal to a bar by magnitude of a bar. Otherwise 1 by a magnitude of a bar into a bar. So this is the unit vector finding purpose we use. Next concept, component of vector. So So component form of a vector as well. So component form, before going to the component form of a vector, we'll see the component vector, components of a vector. First of all, I'll draw the right angle system in 3D space, x axis, y axis and z axis. This is the point A, point B and point C. So point A I am taking 100 on x axis, y and z values will be 0, on y axis x z 0, on z axis x y 0 and z is 1. So now arrow marks, if we are taking, this is the origin O, origin O, and having R having 1 unit, so magnitude of OA bar equal to 1, magnitude of OB bar equal to 1, magnitude of OC bar equal to 1. So every vector having magnitude is 1. So these three vectors are OA bar, OB bar, OC bar are unit vectors. Unit vectors along axis OX, OY and OZ. So unit vectors along X axis, Y axis, Z axis are OA bar, OB bar, OC bar and denoted by I cap, J cap, K cap. Cap is nothing but it is a unit vector. So this one will write as an I cap, this is a J cap, this is K cap. So these are the unit vectors along the X axis, Y axis and Z axis. So now I will take the one more diagram. Same to same, this is the origin O, this is x axis, y axis, z axis. Next one, I am taking here P, Q, R and S. If you are taking this one as a P1, the point is x comma, y comma, z. If you are taking 1 unit along x axis, y axis, z axis, 1 unit how much we are taking? I cap, j cap, k cap. So x units is there here. So this will become x I cap. Next step, here, y j cap, z k cap, z k cap. So x axis side is there, x I cap, y axis side, y j cap, z k cap. Why? Because 1 unit is I cap. X units means 1 pen cost is 4 rupees, 5 pen cost means 5 into 4, 20 will write. Like that only. This is total X unit distance is there. So X unit distance is there. So X I cap we have to take. By this diagram, if you join this one, by this diagram, you have to simplify the OP bar, position vector. Therefore, position vector OP bar is equal to x I cap, y j cap plus z k cap. Directly I am representing a position vector. Actually process is that to find the position vector. That process is no need to read here. Just you have to remember OP bar or general vector we can write R bar also. This is the R bar vector is x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. Where x comma y comma z are scalar components. Scalar components and x I cap, y j cap, z k cap are vector components. Vector components of R bar. Vector components of R bar. This form is known as a component form of a vector. This form known as component form. If any vector is in the form of x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap, then the type of vector form is called a component form of a vector. By this one, R bar, magnitude of R bar is equal to square root of x square plus y square plus z square. So this form is known as a component form of vector. Components of a vector is nothing but x I, y j, z k are components. If sum is there, that is a component form of a vector. We lose a lot of places this component form, based upon this component form only, we will learn the total exercises. One more point based upon component forms. Note, if A bar and B bar are two vectors in the component form, two vectors they are given in component form, that are A bar is A1 I cap plus A2 j cap plus A3 k cap, B bar equal to B1 I cap plus B2 j cap plus B3 k cap, then the sum of A bar and B bar is the sum of the two vectors. When the two vectors in component form, A bar plus B bar equal to corresponding coefficient addition. Here, I cap. If you take the common I cap, A2 plus B2 J cap, A3 plus B3 K cap. This is the addition of two vectors. Any one example I'll write here. Example 2 I cap plus 3 J cap plus 4 K cap. B bar equal to 5 I cap plus 6 J cap plus 7 K cap. So then A bar plus B bar. How will we write it? Addition of first one. 2 plus 5 is 7 I cap plus 3 plus 6 9 J cap plus 7 plus 4 is 11 k cap. So this is the addition process for the vectors in component forms. Next, the difference of A bar and B bar. How will I write A bar minus B bar? So first element, A1 minus B1 I cap, A2 minus B2 J cap, plus A3 minus B3 J cap. So now, by the example, A bar minus B bar equal to 2 minus 5 is minus 3 I cap, 3 minus 6 is minus 3 J cap, 4 minus 7 is minus 3 k cap. So this is our example for subtraction. Next step, number 3. The vectors A bar and B bar are equal. a bar and b bar equal if and only if and only if a1 equal to b1, a2 equal to b2, a3 equal to b3, a1 equal to b1, a2 equal to b2, a3 equal to b3 is that, then the two vectors are equal vectors. Components, scalar components must and should be equal, then the two vectors are equal vectors. Next step. Number four. The multiplication of vector a bar by a scalar. Multiplication of vector a bar by scalar lambda is. Lambda is given by lambda a bar is equal to lambda a1 I cap plus lambda a2 j cap plus lambda a3 k cap. So every element you have to multiply with lambda. Every scalar component multiply with lambda. Next one. Like one more note point, this one a bar and b bar vectors m ds scalar k comma m scalars, then it will satisfy some property k a bar plus m a bar is equal to, we can write this one as a distributive property km into a bar. Next, the second one k into m a bar is there, that time also we can change this one as a km into a bar also we can write. Constants k and m are scalars, nothing but constant. A bar is a vector. Next, number 3, k into a bar plus b bar, distributive property apply, k into a bar plus k into b bar, k into a bar plus k into b bar. One important point is there. Important point here, if two vectors a bar and b bar collinear means what? It is parallel to the one same line. Two or more vectors parallel to the one same line, then the vectors are called collinear vectors. But always we won't draw a line in that, all things we can't write. When component forms is there, that time we have to follow the one rule. If and only if there exists a lambda such that b bar equal to lambda a bar. B bar equal to lambda a bar. Lambda is a scalar. Like this, if you are writing the two vectors, then the two vectors are collinear. This is important one. Collinear checking purpose will use this property. B bar equal to lambda a bar. So by this one, we'll complete the total concepts. And next class, we'll continue the example problems. Thank you.